Good morning, dear students. Today, we are going to start reading the next chapter from the book Moments, chapter number 5, The Happy Prince, which is written by Oscar Wilde. Students, in this chapter, we see that the prince was very happy when he was alive. So we see that the happiness of the prince, because at that time when he was alive, there were no miseries in his kingdom. But now, as soon as the chapter opens, we see that the happy prince is not happy. He has died and his statue has been established on a high platform of the city. Now let us start reading the text of the chapter. High above the city, on a tall column, stood the statue of the happy prince. He was gilded all over with thin leaves of fine gold. For eyes, he had two bright sapphires, and a large red ruby glowed on his sword hilt. So in the first paragraph of this chapter, we can see that the prince is not happy, means high above the city. He has died and his statue has been established on a high platform. But the statue is decorated with the beautiful ornaments. We can see the names of the beautiful ornaments like fine gold, bright sapphires, and large red ruby. Large red ruby glowed on his sword hilt, means the sword of the prince statue was decorated, was glowed with that of this large red ruby. And his eyes were decorated with the beautiful sapphires. He was gilded. Gilded means decorated, shining. He was gilded all over with thin leaves of fine gold. His full body was also decorated with the gold metal. So now we can say that in the first paragraph, the beauty of the statue has been described to us. One night there flew over the city a little swallow. His friends had gone away to Egypt 6 weeks before, but he had stayed behind. Then he decided to go to Egypt too. Who is a swallow? Swallow is a bird. Swallow is a tiny bird. So one night what happened? During that time when he was flying over the city, the word he refers to the little swallow here. Otherwise, for the birds, we can use the pronoun it. But here, in these lines, we are referring the pronoun he for the swallow bird. When he was moving around the city, he could see the statue of the happy prince. And he was going to Egypt because all his friends, means rest all of the birds, had already gone to Egypt. But he had not gone there, and now he is also moving to the same place. All day long he flew, and at night time he arrived at the city. So for the full day he was flying, and at night time he felt tired and he arrived at the city. Where shall I put up? The meaning of put up means stay. So he was thinking that where could he stay to take rest. He said, I hope the town has made preparations. So now he thought that the town has definitely made some preparations to stay. So then he saw the statue on the tall column. I will put up there, he cried. It is a fine position with plenty of fresh air. So he alighted just between the feet of the happy prince. So when he was moving through that town, he saw the statue of the happy prince. And he thought that it is a nice place to stay here. It is a nice place to take rest. So he thought that I could take rest here just at the feet of the happy prince. And he stayed there. I have a golden bedroom, he said softly to himself as he looked round and he prepared to go to sleep. But just as he was putting his head under his wing, a large drop of water fell on him. What a curious thing, he cried. There is not a single cloud in the sky. The stars are quite clear and bright, and yet it is raining. Then another drop fell. So what happens when he was taking the rest at the feet of the happy prince statue, he thought that it is a very golden bedroom. The word golden refers to the nice place at the feet of the happy prince, because he was very happy while taking rest and he prepared himself for the sleep. But after some time, he felt that a large drop of water fell on him and he was surprised. It was very strange thing for him, because at that time there were no clouds, so he could not imagine that the rain could be there. So he was surprised why that drop of water fell on him. He looked at the sky and the sky was totally clear. The stars are quite clear and bright, but yet it is raining. Then suddenly what happened? Another drop also fell on him and he felt that from where he is getting wet. What is the use of a statue if it cannot keep the rain off? He said, I must look for a good chimney pot, and he determined to fly away. So when he was feeling that the drops of the water are falling on him, then he thought that if he is taking the rest under the shadow of the happy prince, then there is no need of this statue, because it cannot protect him from the rain. Then he determined to fly away, that he should leave that place. But before he had opened his wings, a third drop fell, and he looked up and saw, oh, what did he see? But when the third drop also fell on him, then he looked up and he was surprised. Why was he surprised? We will see. The eyes of the happy prince were filled with tears, and tears were running down his golden cheeks. His face was so beautiful in the moonlight that the little swallow was filled with pity. So what did he see when he just looked his eyes up, and then he looked through his eyes up, and then he felt that the eyes of the happy prince were actually filled with tears. So from there only the drops of the water were coming down. His face was very beautiful in the moonlight. So we are talking about the statue's face here. And the little swallow was filled with pity. The little fellow was not liking it that this statue was crying. Who are you? He said. So he refers to again the swallow bird here. He is asking the question from the happy prince, like, who are you? Then the happy prince replied, I am the happy prince. As soon as the bird looked up, he saw that the eyes of the happy prince were filled with tears. These drops of water were the teardrops falling off the statue's golden cheeks. When swallow looked at happy prince's face, it was looking very beautiful in the moonlight. The little bird's heart filled with pity for the weeping statue. It asked the statue that who it was. The statue replied that it was happy prince. So it is described already to you that this is the reply of the happy prince, that I am the happy prince, and the water was falling down from his eyes only. Then why are you weeping? Then asked the swallow. Again the swallow asked one more question, that if you are the happy prince, then why are you crying? Because you have quite drenched me also. What is the meaning of drenched? Drenched means soaked with water, means the swallow bird got wet. When I was alive and had a human heart, answered the statue, I didn't know what tears were, for I lived in the palace where sorrow is not allowed to enter. Now the story started. Now the prince is telling the story that when he was alive, and he is saying that when he was alive, he had a human heart and he was very happy. I didn't know what tears were. And even he is saying that at that time, he did not even know the meanings of tears, because he could never see the miseries in his kingdom. My courtiers called me the happy prince. So this is the reason that all the courtiers of his kingdom, they used to call him the happy prince. And happy indeed I was. So the statue is saying, really I was very happy. So I lived and so I died, and now that I am dead, they have set me up here so high that I can see the ugliness and all the misery of my city. And though my heart is made of lead, yet I cannot choose but weep. So now the happy prince is saying that when he got died, the people of the kingdom, the people of the city, they have established his statue here at the top of the high city. It means now he is no more, but he could see the sufferings of the kingdom. And that is why he is not feeling good and he is crying. What is he not solid gold? Said the swallow to himself. He was too polite to make any personal remarks. The swallow bird was very polite while asking the questions from the happy prince. Far away, continued the statue in a low musical voice, far away in a little street there is a poor house. One of the windows is opened and through I can see a woman seated at a table. Her face is thin and worn and she has coarse red hands all pricked by the needle, for she is a seamstress. So now the happy prince is telling us about the miseries of a girl, the miseries of a lady. So what does he say? He says that there is a poor house and one of the windows is open. Through it I can see the miseries of a woman. She is sitting here at a table and her face is very thin. She is very very poor woman. And what her work is? She is a seamstress. What is the meaning of seamstress? Seamstress is that woman who makes her earning just by sewing the clothes. So she was very poor woman and she had to suffer a lot in his life, which the happy prince could not see. She is embroidering flowers on a satin gown for the loveliest of the queen's maids of honor to wear at the next court ball. In a bed in the corner of the room, her little boy is lying ill. So now the author is saying us about the miseries of the lady. What has she suffered? She is a very poor woman and she is embroidering. Her work is to sweep cloths and now she is embroidering flowers on a satin gown for the loveliest of the queen's maids of honor. And this dress she was preparing for the queen so that she could wear in the next court ball. What is the meaning of ball? Ball means party. In a bed in the corner of the room, her little boy is lying ill. And even her little boy is not feeling well. He is suffering from extreme fever. He has a fever and is asking his mother to give him oranges. Means he has not eaten. Her son has not eaten anything and he wanted some oranges to eat, but she did not have anything to give him so that he could recover from his illness. So this type of misery the happy prince could not see. And he was filled with pity and he wanted to help that lady. His mother has nothing to give him but river water. So he is crying, "Swallow, swallow, little swallow, will you not bring her the ruby out of my sword hilt? My feet are fastened to this pedestal and I cannot move." So at this, the happy prince is requesting to the swallow bird to help him in this matter, because he is a statue. The happy prince is just as a statue and he cannot move anywhere. So that is why he is requesting to the swallow bird to help him in this matter. He could move there to that poor lady to give her one ruby from his sword. So his sword, the happy prince statue's sword, was decorated with the ruby and he wanted that ruby should be taken from the sword and it should be given to that lady so that she could take care of her son. Now, "I am waited for in Egypt," said the swallow. "My friends are flying up and down the Nile and talking to the large lotus flowers. Soon they will go to sleep." But at this, the swallow bird replied that, "No, I have to go to Egypt because all my friends had already gone there 6 weeks ago. I am already late. I have to go along with my friends. I have to enjoy with them like they are enjoying the lotus flowers and the beautiful weather there. I also have to move there, so I cannot help to you. I just stayed here just to take rest." The prince asked the swallow to stay with him for one night and be his messenger. The boy is so thirsty and the mother so sad, he said. Again, the prince requested to the swallow bird that he had to help him because the boy is very thirsty and the mother is very sad. She is helpless. She cannot take care of her ailing son. I don't think I like boys, answered the swallows. I want to go to Egypt. So again the swallow opposed the request and said that it did not like boys. So why should it help that boy? So now he is saying that I should not go there. But the happy prince looked so sad that the little swallow was worried. It was very cold there, he said, but he agreed to stay with him for one night and be his messenger. Thank you, little swallow, said the prince. So finally, happy prince agreed also, but ultimately, earlier he was not saying that I can go there, but afterwards when he noticed that the happy prince is becoming very sad, then he agreed to the request. He agreed to the request, and at this, the happy prince thanked the swallow bird. The swallow picked out the great ruby from the prince's sword and flew away with it in his beak over the roofs of the town. So finally, he took the ruby from the prince's sword and went there to help to that lady. He passed by the cathedral tower where the white marble angels were sculptured. He passed by the palace and heard the sound of dancing. So when he was moving towards that place, and then he felt that he had to pass, the swallow bird passed the cathedral. Cathedral is a church. And on the church towers, white colored marble angels were sculptured. So he reached that palace and crossed the palace. He could hear the sound of the dancing girl also from the way where he was moving. A beautiful girl came out on the balcony with her lover. I hope my dress will be ready in time for the state ball, she said. I have ordered flowers to be embroidered on it, but the seamstresses are so lazy. So what did the swallow bird notice? He noticed that at that time there was a beautiful girl. That beautiful girl was actually the queen for whom the seamstress was sewing the cloths, was preparing a gown, and she was talking with her lover that she is hoping that her dress might be ready by the seamstress. But she says to the lover that the seamstresses are very lazy because that queen, that beautiful girl, did not know about the miseries of that seamstress. He passed over the river and saw the lanterns hanging on the mast of the ship. At last he came to the poor woman's house and looked in. So after crossing so many places, like when the swallow bird flew over this river, ships also came along the way. So these are the names of the places from where he was moving, and ultimately he reached to that poor woman's house also. The boy was tossing feverishly on his bed. Means the boy was suffering from extreme fever and the mother had fallen asleep. She was so tired. The mother, he found that was sleeping because she was very tired. In he hopped and laid the great ruby on the table beside the woman's thimble. So at this, the swallow bird just kept that ruby at the side of the table where the woman was sleeping. So now he flew gently round the bed, fanning the boy's forehead with his wings. How cool I feel, said the boy. I must be getting better, and he sank into a delicious slumber. The meaning of slumber means sleep. Then at this, he flew. Again, the word he refers to the swallow bird. He says that he flew gently round the bed. When he found that the boy was suffering from extreme fever, he started fanning that boy's from his wings. And at this, the boy also felt comfortable. He liked it. And he said to himself, I must be getting better. And he sank into a delicious slumber. The meaning of delicious is not sweet here. The meaning of delicious is sound sleep. Means delicious slumber means sound sleep. The boy could have the sound sleep when he was fanned by the swallow bird. Then the swallow flew back to the happy prince and told him what he had done. So now the whole story is told to the happy prince, whatsoever he had seen, means the swallow bird had seen during his way. It is curious, he remarked, but I feel quite warm now, although it is so cold. So earlier the swallow bird was feeling very cold, but now he is saying to the happy prince that now, even after it is very cold, but still I am feeling that it is warm. That is because you have done a good action, said the prince. So at this, the prince said to the swallow bird, because you have done a very kind work, a very generous action. So that this is the reason that you are feeling warm. And the little swallow began to think and then fall asleep. Thinking always made him sleepy. So when he was thinking, he felt asleep. When day broke, he flew down to the river and had a bath. Tonight I go to Egypt, said the swallow, and he was in high spirits at the prospect. So the next morning, now he just broke, he flew down to the river. When he went to the river, he thought that now it is the time that I have to move to the Egypt, because prospect means thought of something. So he was thinking of something. What was his thinking? That he became happy that I could move to that place from where he had to go, and he was very happy. He visited all the monuments and sat a long time on top of the church steeple. What is the meaning of steeple? Steeple means high tower of the church. So he visited all the monuments of the city and finally he went and sat on the high tower of the church. When the moon rose, he flew back to the happy prince. Have you any commissions for Egypt? He cried. I am just starting. So at this, when it was night, the moon rose in the sky and he was talking about his way to Egypt to happy prince, because he was taking permission from the happy prince. Now, could he move to Egypt? Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince, will you stay with me one night longer? I am waited for in Egypt, answered the swallow. So at this also, the happy prince again said that, swallow, swallow, little swallow, could you stay with me one more night? Now at this, the swallow bird replied, I am waited for in Egypt. I have to go there. My all the friends have already gone there and I also have to go there. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince, far away across the city, I saw a young man in a garret. He is leaning over a desk covered with papers, and in the glass by his side, there is a bunch of withered violets. So now, the happy prince wants to help one more person. So who is that one more person? A young man who is sitting in a garret. What is the meaning of garret? Garret is a small dark room at the top of any house. So he was also a miserable man. He was a playwright and his condition was not up to the mark whatsoever the happy prince had noticed. His hair is brown and crisp and his lips are red as a pomegranate and he has large and dreamy eyes. Further, the happy prince means gave a description of that boy. He said that his hair was brown and crisp, which means that he had not taken bath for a long time, and his lips were lit like a pomegranate and he had big dreamy eyes, which means that the boy was very ambitious and hard working. That boy, that young man about him the happy prince was talking, was a very hard working man. He is trying to finish a play for the director of the theater, but he is too cold to write any more. So he was a playwright, as I have told you. So he was writing the play for the director of the theater, but his fingers were not working because it was very cold and he was sitting in the garret where he could not enjoy the warmth of fire because he was a very poor young man and his hunger also could make him faint. This type of misery also could not be seen by the happy prince and he wanted to help that young man. I will wait with you one night longer, said the swallow, who really had a good heart. He asked if he should take another ruby to the young playwright. So now the swallow understood what happy prince was trying to tell him. So he is saying that again you want to help this young man, and he said that the swallow bird asked the happy prince if he should take another ruby stone to give it to the young playwright, just like he had given to that old lady, isn't it? Means he knew the decision of the happy prince, what actually he wanted. "Alas, I have no ruby now," said the prince. But when the prince found that there was no more ruby in the sword, then he got worried. "My eyes are all that I have left. They are made of rare sapphires, which were brought out of India 1,000 years ago." So now the happy prince said that he had beautiful eyes which are decorated with the rare sapphires. So it was brought from India 1,000 years before. So the swallow bird should take that ruby from his sapphire from his eyes, and he should help that young man so that he could come out of his miserable condition. He ordered the swallow to pluck out one of them and take it to the playwright. So similarly, he ordered to the swallow bird to take that ruby, to take that that sapphire from his eyes, and it should be given to that young man. He will sell it to the jeweler and buy firewood and finish his play. So the happy prince said that by giving this sapphire to the young man, the young man can sell it to the jeweler and can take some money so that he can purchase the firewood for himself and he can enjoy the warmth of that. "Dear prince," said the swallow, "I cannot do that," and he began to weep. And at this the swallow bird said that, "No, I cannot do this thing." "Swallow, swallow, little swallow," said the prince, do as I command you." So at this the happy prince said that, "You have to just obey my instructions. You have to do whatever I am saying to you." So the swallow plucked out the prince's eye and flew away to the young man's garret. So at this again the swallow bird agreed to the instructions of the happy prince, and he got ready to help that young man who was sitting in the garret. It was easy enough to get in, as there was a hole in the roof. Though this he darted and came into the room, the young man had his head buried in his hands, so he did not bear the flutter of the bird's wings. And when he looked up, he found the beautiful sapphire lying on the withered violets. So what happened? When the swallow bird entered there, it was very easy way to get inside that garret, and there was a hole in the roof, so he could easily get in there. And when he went there, the young man had his head buried in his hand. So he, at this, by doing this, he could not listen the sound, the fluttering sound of the bird's wings. And when he looked up, he found that the beautiful sapphire was just there on the withered violets, and obviously he got surprised. "I am beginning to be appreciated," he cried. Now who is he? He is a young man, a playwright, for whom the happy prince had helped by giving his sapphire from his eyes. So this is from some great admirer. But the young man thought that it was given to him by one of his great admirer of his plays. "Now I can finish my play," and he looked quite happy. So by getting that sapphire, the young man got very happy, and he thought that he could finish his play very easily now. The next day the swallow flew down to the harbor. He sat on the mast of a large vessel and watched the sailors working. "I am going to Egypt," cried the swallow, but nobody minded. And when the moon rose, he flew back to the happy prince. So next morning the swallow bird flew down to the harbor and sat on a mast of a ship, and he spoke loudly that, "Finally, I have to go to Egypt." And when it was night, he went back, he flew back to the happy prince to say this. "I have come to bid you goodbye," he cried. What is the meaning of cried here? Cried means here showing his anger also, and showing his happiness also, that he had to move to Egypt and he is just giving goodbye to the happy prince. "Swallow, swallow, little swallow," said the prince, "will you not stay with me one night longer?" So at this also the happy prince wanted that the swallow bird should stay with him for one more night. "It is winter," answered the swallow, "and the snow will soon be here. In Egypt the sun is warm on the green palm trees, and the crocodiles lie in the mud and look lazily about them." So at this the swallow bird replied that, "I cannot bear this cold weather, and very soon there will be snow, and in Egypt the weather is very comfortable, so I have to go there." In the square below, said the happy prince, there stands a little match girl. She has let her matches fall in the gutter and they all are spoilt. Her father will beat her if she does not bring some money home. And she is crying. She has no shoes or stockings and her little head is bare. Pluck out my other eye and give it to her and her father will not beat her. So at this, the happy prince wanted to help one more person. Who is that person? Now a little match girl. The happy prince wanted to help a little match girl. She is also a very poor girl and she earns her living just by making the matchsticks. But all the matchsticks had already been fallen in the gutter. So now she is crying because her father is also dependent upon her earnings and she is fearing that her father will definitely beat her if she goes to home empty-handed. And she is crying, there are no shoes in her feet and no stockings and her little head is also bare. So this type of suffering is also not seen by the happy prince and he decides to help that little girl also. For this again, the happy prince wants the help of the swallow bird so that he could take another sapphire from another eye and he could give to that little match girl. I will stay with you one night longer, said the swallow, but I cannot pluck out your eye. You would be quite blind then. So at this, the swallow bird said that I can stay with you, but I cannot take the sapphire from your eyes because you will be blind otherwise. Both the sapphires will be taken out, so you will be blind. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince, do as I command you. So again, the happy prince said to the swallow bird that you just have to obey my instruction. You can take the sapphire from my eye and you have to give it to the girl. So he plucked out the prince's other eye and darted down with it. He swooped past the match girl and slipped the drill into the palm of her hand. What a lovely bit of glass, cried the little girl, and she ran home laughing. So again, he plucked out the prince's other eye and helped that match girl by getting that drill, and she became very happy because now she doesn't have any fear to go to her home empty-handed. Then the swallow came back to the prince. You are blind now, he said, so I will stay with you always. When swallow returned to the happy prince, he told him that now he is blind, so he cannot leave him. He will stay along with him because he is blind. He was very kind. The swallow bird was also very kind and he could not see the miseries of the happy prince also. So no, little swallow, said the poor prince, you must go away to Egypt. At this, the prince said to the swallow that you have to go there. You do not stay here. You just move to your way. No, I will stay with you always, said the swallow, and he slept at the prince's feet. So he slept at the prince's feet and agreed that I will definitely stay with you forever. All the next day he sat on the prince's shoulder and told him stories of what he had seen in strange lands. So the swallow bird used to sit on the happy prince's shoulder and told. He said that I will tell you about the different places, that what are the miseries of the people, and I will tell about the miseries of the people what I have seen. So dear little swallow, said the prince, you tell me of the marvelous things, but more marvelous than anything is the suffering of men and women. There is no misery so great as misery. Fly over my city, little swallow, and tell me what you see there. So at this, prince said that, of course, you have to tell me the miseries of the poor people, and if I can help them, I will try my best to help them. So the swallow flew over the great city and saw the rich making merry in their beautiful houses while the beggars were sitting at the gates. He flew into dark lanes and saw the white faces of starving children looking out listlessly at the black streets. So at this, the swallow bird It flew over the city and found that the rich persons are very rich. They are enjoying a lot, whereas some of the people are very poor. They are beggars. They do not have anything and they are sitting at the gates. He flew into the dark lanes also. He saw the white faces of some starving children. Starving means hungry children. So he just had the list of these types of people of the black streets who were suffering from troubles. Under the archway of a bridge, two little boys were lying in each other's arms to try and keep themselves warm. Now further, the swallow bird saw two little boys also who were under the archway of the bridge, and they were lying much close to each other so that they could feel themselves warm. It shows the poverty of the boys. How hungry we are, they said. They were talking. The boys were talking with themselves that they were very hungry. You must not lie here, shouted the watchman. And even the watchman also shouted at them. The watchman did not allow to stay there, and they wandered out into the rain. So at this, those boys, they had to move into the rain even. Then he flew back and told the prince what he had seen. So the whole scenario he told to the happy prince. I am covered with fine gold, said the prince. You must take it off leaf by leaf and give it to the poor. The living always think that gold can make them happy. So now the happy prince said that my full body is decorated with the leaves which are made of the gold ornament. So you have to take these leaves one by one and you have to help these poor people. So leaf after leaf of the fine gold the swallow picked off till the happy prince looked quite dull and grey. So the swallow bird just started picking the leaf from the body of the happy prince and started giving to the poor and the miserable people. By doing this, the happy prince was no longer beautiful because all the ornaments had already been taken from the body. Leaf after leaf of the fine gold he brought to the poor, and the children's faces grew rosier and they laughed and played in the street. We have bread now, they cried. So now when the swallow bird had helped all the poor people by giving them the leaf which are made of the gold ornament, they became very happy because they did not have to face now hunger, starvation. They could earn the bread easily. Then the snow came, and after the snow came the frost. So now it is very cold. It started snowing, and when a lot of snow fell, there was freezing even. Everything froze. The streets looked as if they were made of silver. Everybody went about in furs, and the little boys wore scarlet caps and skated on the ice. So everybody was very happy when they were helped by the swallow bird and the happy prince. The poor little swallow grew colder and colder. The poor little swallow bird was also feeling so cold, but he would not leave the prince. He did not leave the prince. He loved him too well. Swallow bird was feeling very cold, but he kept on sitting with him. He picked up crumbs outside the baker's store when the baker was not looking and tried to keep himself warm by flapping his wings. So it shows that the swallow bird was also facing lots of cold and it was unbearable for him. He did not want to die, so he used to go to the bakery where the baker used to bake the bread so that he could feel the warmth. But at last he knew that he was going to die. So ultimately the swallow bird also knew that I am just about to die. He had just enough strength to fly up to the prince's shoulder once more. He went to the prince. Goodbye, dear prince, he murmured. Will you let me kiss your hand? Now when the swallow is about to die, he again means he goes to the happy prince and he just wants to show his love towards the happy prince. And at this, I am glad that you are going to Egypt at last, little swallow, said the prince. But the prince thought that he is saying so because he had to go to Egypt. You have stayed too long here, but you must kiss me on the lips, for I love you. It is not to Egypt that I am going, said the swallow. I am going to the house of death. Death is the brother of sleep, is he not? And he kissed the happy prince on the lips and fell down dead at his feet. So at this, the swallow bird said that, no, I am not going to Egypt. I am going to the house of the death. Means I am going to the heaven because I cannot live anymore. I am just about to die. And that is why I want to show my love to you. So at this, he just fell down at the feet of the happy prince. At that moment, a curious crack sounded inside the statue, as if something had broken. The fact is that the legend hurt had snapped right in two. It certainly was a dreadfully hard frost. So when the statue, means the statue of the happy prince, came to know that it had happened, suddenly there was a sound of the crack inside the statue. It shows that the heart of the statue had broken. So now, because he was completely hurt by seeing this thing, that the swallow bird was very kind and generous and it had died. Early the next morning, the mayor was walking in the square below in company with the town councillor. As they passed the column, he looked up at the statue. "Dear me, how shabby the happy prince looks," he said. So the next morning, what happens? The mayor of the city, along with his councillors, they were walking towards that place where the statue of the happy prince was established. They got surprised to see the miserable condition of the statue, and they were saying that it is looking very untidy. Shabby means worn out, untidy. "So how shabby indeed," cried the town councillors. Even the town councillors also said that it was really very shabby, very poor, who always agreed with the mayor, and they went up to look at it. Everybody was looking at that statue. "The ruby has fallen out of his sword, his eyes are gone, and he is golden no longer," said the mayor. So the mayor is saying that all the ornaments had been taken away from the body of the statue. So now it is no longer beautiful. In fact, he is little better than a beggar. Means the mayor is saying that the condition of the statue of the happy prince even is just like the condition of a beggar. "So little beggar, just then a beggar," said the councillors also, as the councillors always agreed to the statement of the mayor, whatsoever he had said. "And here is actually a dead bird at his feet," continued the mayor. "We must really issue a proclamation that the birds are not to be allowed to die here." And the town clerk made a note of the suggestion. So what happened when they found that the dead body of the swallow bird, they said that it is not at all allowed to die at the feet of the statue here. So now they consider that it should not be done. So they should, the town clerk also made a note of that suggestion given by the mayor. So they pulled down the statue of the happy prince. "As he is no longer beautiful and he is no longer useful," said the art professor at the university. So even at the art professor at the university also declared this thing, that the statue of the happy prince is no longer beautiful. So what did they do? Then they melted the statue in a furnace. So they melted the statue, which was made of fleet, in a furnace. "What a strange thing," said the overseer of the workmen at the foundry. So the supervisor of the foundry also saw that strange thing. "This broken lead heart will not melt in the furnace. We must throw it away." But they found that the heart was not getting melt, and they got surprised, and they thought that it should be just thrown away. So they threw it on a dust heap where the dead swallow was also lying. When the heart was not getting melt, so they threw it to that place where the dead body of the swallow bird was also lying. "So bring me the two most precious things in the city," said God to one of his angels, and the angel brought him the leaden heart and the dead bird. Now we are just referring these lines to that of the God. "Me" is God here. So God is saying to the angel that you have to bring two most precious things from the earth. Now when the angel went there, so she found two most precious things. What are these two most precious things? The most precious things are the leaden heart of the king and the dead bird. "You have rightly chosen," said God, "for in my garden of paradise this little bird shall sing forevermore, and in my city of gold the happy prince shall praise me." So at this, the God also said this thing to the angel, that "You have rightly chosen, your choice is correct, you have taken the right decision, that the statue, the heart of the statue and the dead swallow bird, these are two most precious things, and it will stay here in the heaven, and this little this swallow bird will sing forever in our kingdom here, in our place here, and the happy prince statue will be admired by everyone. So this is the full explanation of this chapter, The Happy Prince. I hope this story is understood to all of you. You can see even the written explanation through the attached PDF also, which is sent to you. Thank you.